Hi, my name's Justin Schneider. I'm your Michigan agronomist here with Great Lakes Hybrids. And today for your agronomic tip of the week, we're going to discuss plot evaluation. Now that harvest is here, it's a great time, especially on a rainy day. We've had quite a few of them here in Michigan the last couple weeks, to get out there and evaluate your local Great Lakes Hybrids plot and see how the newer hybrids are performing and a lot of the experimentals. It's also a good time to compare a lot of your main key Great Lakes hybrids to a lot of competitors. With early orders fastly approaching, it just helps in the decision-making process. So when you're looking at a Great Lakes hybrids plot, what should you be evaluating? I'll go through a couple key things that I like to evaluate as I walk through a plot. First thing, I always like to look at stalk quality. Are we seeing any lodging here with any of the stalks? Are you able to pinch together any of the bottom nodes? You know, how is the stock quality with this hybrid? The next one is kind of depending on your row spacing. Some guys, if you're in narrower rows, 20 to 22 inch rows, you like to look at leaf orientation. Are the leaves more upright and closer to the stock? If so, that's a hybrid that will perform well in narrow rows. Another good one is leaf disease. You always like to kind of look at all the leaves. Are you seeing a lot of northern corn leaf blight? Gray leaf spot, those are the two big diseases you deal with here in Michigan. Kind of evaluate the hybrid performance from there. Another one's grain quality. You always want to kind of pull, husk the ear back, check for grain quality, you know, how big is the cob, kernel size, and stuff like that. Another one is kind of fall intactness. What's the harvestability going to look like? Are the tops breaking all over? Is it still standing very nice? Kind of the grain's dried down, but the plant still has a little bit of greenness to it. Stay green. How well can that plant stay healthy? So that means it can sit a little bit longer out in the field. Kind of the last one I like to look at, especially here in Michigan, is husk cover. We have an ear mold issue quite a few years, so we always like to promote hybrids that'll have a loose husk, so it will kind of avoid gibberella. That's our biggest ear mold issue here in Michigan. So look for stuff that has a loose husk, especially here in Michigan. Nice grain, leaf disease, stalk quality, those are some major things to evaluate when you're walking your local Great Lakes Hybrids plot. And I guess that's all I have for today. So yeah, go out there, evaluate your local Great Lakes Hybrids plot. And if you'd like agronomist or DSM to walk that plot with you, just give us a call. Thank you.